Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject fluid mechanics in machines. And this is lecture number 5.3. We are going to solve problems in fluid dynamics and flow meters. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed the Euler's equation, Bernoulli's equation, flow measuring devices like venturi meter, orifice meter, flow nozzle, rotameter, pitot tube, and we discuss the momentum equation. And in this lecture, we will be solving the problems on fluid dynamics and flow meters. The learning outcome to the lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in fluid dynamics and flow meters. Problem number 1 from May 2010 question paper. The pressure between two points M and N in a pipe conveying oil of specific gravity 0.9 is measured by an inverted U-tube and the column connected to a point N is 1.5 meter higher than that point M. A commercial pressure gauge directly attached to the pipe at the M reads 2 kg force per centimeter square. Determine the reading of the gauge when directly attached to the pipe at N. So the specific gravity of the oil flowing in the pipeline is 0.9. So the density is 900 kilograms per meter cube. So specific gravity into 1000 is the density. Zm equal to Zn equal to Zm plus 1.5. So it is mentioned that point N is 1.5 meter higher than that at point M. So Zm plus 1.5 equal to Zn. And there is a pressure measuring device at the point M. It indicates 2 kg force per centimeter square. And apply the Bernoulli's equation between the two points M and M in the pipeline without losses. The Bernoulli's equation without any pipe losses. Pressure head Pm by W, there is specific weight rho g, Vm square by 2g plus Zm equal to Pn by W, which is again rho g plus Vn square by 2g plus Zn. So, for constant area pipe, horizontal pipe, Zm equal to Zn. So, the equation is simplified Pm by W plus Zm equal to Pn by W plus Zn. So, pressure at the point M, we have to calculate pressure at the point N. So, in the equation, rearrange the terms Pn by W equal to Pm by W plus Zm minus Zn. So, substituting numerical values, 2 into 9.81 into 10 power 4. So, 2 kilogram force per centimeter square. So, to convert kilogram force into Newton, we have to multiply by 9.81. To convert centimeter square into meter square, we have to multiply by 10 power 4. So, 9.81 into 10 power 4 divided by W, specific weight equal to rho into g, so 900 into 9.81 minus Zm minus Z1 equal to 1.5, so which is 20.72 meter. So Pn equal to 20.72 into again specific weight 900 into 9.81 equal to 182.9 in 10 power 3 newtons per meter square. So the pressure at the point N is 182.9 in 10 power 3 newtons per meter square. Example number 2 from November 2013 question paper. A horizontal venturi meter with the inlet and the throat diameter 300 mm and 100 mm respectively is used to measure the pressure of the flow of water. The pressure intensity at the inlet is 130 kN per meter square, while the vacuum pressure head at the throat is 350 mm of mercury. Assuming that 33% head lost between the inlet and the throat, find the value of the coefficient of discharge for venturi meter and also determine the rate of flow. So we are given diameter, inlet diameter is 0.3 meter, throat diameter is 0.1 meter, pressure at the point 1, inlet is 130 kilometers per meter square, pressure at the throat is minus 350 millimeter of mercury. So loss of pressure head between inlet and the outlet is 3, inlet and the throat is 3%. So area at inlet and the throat, A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square. area at the throat A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 0.00785 meter square. So pressure head at the inlet and the throat. So H1 equal to P1 by rho G. 130 into 10 power 3 divided by 1000, rho is 1000, g is 9.81, so which is 13.25 meter of water column. H2, head at the throat section, it is, we are given head in mercury column, mercury value, mercury column, we have to convert into water column, so multiplying by specific gravity of mercury. So minus of 0.35, because it is vacuum pressure, minus of 0.35 into 13.6 equal to minus of 4.76 meter of water. The head difference H equal to H1 minus H2. So, which is 13.25 plus 4.76 equal to 18.01 meter of water. Now, the coefficient of discharge. So, CD, it is defined as square root of H minus HF divided by H. So, substituting 18.01 minus 3 HF equal to 3 percentage of H. So, 0.03 into 18.01 divided by 18.01 equal to 0.985. Now, the rate of flow Q equal to the equation for venturi meter CD into A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. So, substituting all numerical values, discharge Q equal to 0.985 into 0.07065 into 0.00785 divided by square root of 0.07065 square minus 0.00785 square into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 18.01. So, calculating discharge or the flow rate is 0.146 meter cube per second, which is 146 liters per second. Example number 3, air flows through a pipe at a rate of 200 lps. The pipe consists of two sections of diameter 20 cm and 10 cm with a smooth reduction section that connects them. The pressure difference between the two pipe sections is measured by water manometer. Neglecting frictional effect, determine the differential height of water between the two pipe sections. Take air density to be 1.2 kg per meter cube, and this is from November 2019 question paper. So the diagram is shown here. So we have a pipeline of varying diameter, 20 cm at the inlet and 10 cm at the outlet. It is connected by a U-tube manometer. And the discharge is 200 lps, d1 equal to 0.2 meter, d2 equal to 0.1 meter, density of air rho a equal to 1.2 kg per meter cube. So, the area at the inlet and the outlet, a1 equal to pi by 4 d1 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.2 square equal to 0.0314 meter square, a2 equal to pi by 4 d2 square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 0.00785 meter square. And velocity of air at the two sections, V1 equal to discharge by A1, so 0.2 divided by 0.0314 equal to 6.37 meters per second. V2 equal to Q by A2, which is 0.2 divided by 0.00785 equal to 25.48 meters per second. Now apply the Bernoulli's equation between the section 1 and 2 and take Z1 equal to Z2. So P1 by rho A G, rho A is the density of the air, plus U1 square by 2G equal to P2 by rho AG plus V2 square by 2G. So, rearranging the terms, P1 minus P2 by rho AG equal to V1, V2 square minus V1 square by 2G. So, G you can delete. So, P1 minus P2, the pressure difference P1 minus P2 equal to rho A into V2 square minus V1 square by 2. So, substituting 1.2 into 25.48 square minus 6.37 square divided by 2 equal to 365.2. Newtons per meter square. So, this is the pressure difference. Now, using the pressure difference, we can calculate the head of water column. So, P1 minus P2 equal to rho W G into HW. So, HW equal to P1 minus P2 divided by rho W into G. So, 365.2 divided by 1000 into 9.81 equal to 0.0377 meter or 3.7 centimeter. So, the head of water column here, it is 3.7 centimeter for the given information. Example number 4 from May 2007 question paper, a horizontal venturi meter as shown in the figure of specification 200 millimeter by 100 millimeter is used to measure the discharge of an oil of specific gravity 0.8. A mercury manometer is used for the purpose. If the discharge is 100 liters per second and the coefficient of discharge is 0.98, find the manometer deflection. So, x value we have to calculate. So, d1 equal to 200 millimeter, which is 0.2 meter. d2 equal to 100 millimeter, which is 0.1 meter. Specific gravity is 0.8. So, the density is 800 kilogram per meter cube. Discharge is 100 LPS, which is 110 power minus 3 meter cube per second. And CD equal to 0.98. Now we calculate the area at the inlet and the throat sections of the venturi meter. A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.2 square equal to 0.0314 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 0.00785 meter square. The discharge of the venturi meter, CD, Q equal to CD into A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. So, discharge is given 100 into 10 power minus 3, which is equal to 0.98 into 0.0314 into 0.00785 divided by square root of 0.0314 square minus 0.00785 square into square root of 2G, 2 into 9.81 into H. So, left hand side is 0.1. Right hand side calculating, everything calculating 7.945 into 10 power minus 3. So, within the square root of 19.62 into H. So, solving this equation, H equal to 8.1 meter. For the differential manometer, the deflection X. So, we have H equal to X into SM divided by S minus 1. So, SM is the specific gravity of manometric fluid and S is the specific gravity of the fluid flowing in the pipeline, venturi meter. So, 8.1, H equal to 8.1 into X equal to manometric fluid mercury 13.6. For the fluid oil, it is 0.8 minus 1 is 16X. So, X equal to 5.506 meter or 50.6 centimeter. So, the deflection is 50.6 centimeter. Example number 5 from May 2009 question paper, a horizontal venturi meter as shown in the figure with inlet diameter 20 mm and throat diameter 10 cm, inlet diameter 20 cm and throat diameter 10 cm is used to measure the flow of water. The pressure at inlet is 14.715 newtons per centimeter square and the vacuum pressure at the throat is 40 mm of mercury. Find the discharge of water through the venturi meter. So, we are given diameter D1 equal to 20 cm which is 0.2 meter, D2 equal to 10 cm which is 0.1 meter, pressure P1 equal to 14.715 newtons per centimeter square, P2 equal to minus 40 mm of mercury and we take CD equal to 0.98. So, area at the throat and the inlet, so we calculate A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.2 square equal to 0.0314 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 0.00785 meter square. So, pressure head. So, H1 equal to P1 by rho G. So, 14.75 in 10 power 4 divided by 1000 into 9.81, which is 15 meter of water column. H2 equal to head of the mercury column into specific gravity of the mercury column. So, to convert into water column, we have to convert into water column. So, vacuum pressure is given as minus 40 minus 0.04 into 13.6 equal to minus of 0.5441 meter of water. So, head difference H equal to H1 minus H2. So, 15 plus 0.544 equal to 15.544 meter of water column. Then, the flow rate of water. Q equal to CD into A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. So, substituting numerical values, Q equal to 0.98 into 0.0314 into 0.00785 divided by 0.0 square root of 0.0314 square minus 0.00785 square into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 15.544. So, calculating discharge equal to 0.138 meter cube per second or 138.75 liters per second. Example number 6 from November 2009 question paper. A venturi meter as shown in the figure with 150 mm diameter the inlet and 100 mm throat is laid with its axis horizontal and is used to measure for measuring the flow of oil of specific gravity 0.9. The mercury differential manometer shows a gauge difference of 200 mm. Calculate the discharge. Assume the coefficient of discharge of the meter is 0.98. So we are given D1 equal to 150 mm which is 0.15 meter and D2 equal to 100 mm which is 0.1 meter, CD equal to 0.98, specific gravity is 0.9, X equal to 200 mm which is 0.2 meter. Area at the throat and the inlet, A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.15 square equal to 0.01766 meter square. And A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 0.00785 meter square. So venturi head H equal to X into SM specific gravity of the manometric fluid divided by the specific gravity of the fluid flowing through the pipeline minus 1. So 0.2 into 13.6 divided by 0.9 minus 1. Equal to 2.82 meter. So the flow rate of oil Q equal to CD into A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. So substituting all numerical values Q equal to 0.98 into 0.01766 into 0.00785 divided by square root of 0.01766 square minus 0.00785 square into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 2.82. So calculating discharge Q equal to 0.06388 meter cube per second, which is 63.88 liters per second. Example number 7 from May 2010 and May 2014 question paper. A horizontal venturi meter as shown in the figure with inlet diameter 200 mm and throat diameter 100 mm is employed to measure the flow rate of water. The reading of the differential manometer connected to the inlet and the throat is 180 mm of mercury. If the CD equal to 0.98, determine the flow rate of flow. So the diameter D1 equal to 200 mm which is 0.2 meter, D2 equal to 100 mm which is 0.1 meter, CD equal to 0.98, X equal to 180 mm which is 0.18 meter. So the area at the inlet and the throat, so A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.2 square equal to 0.0314 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 0.00785 meter square. So the venturi head H equal to X into SM divided by S minus 1 which is 0.2 into 13.6 divided by 1. S is the specific gravity of the fluid flowing through the venturi meter, which is water. For water, specific gravity is 1. So 13.6 divided by 1 minus 1, which is 2.268 meter. So the flow rate of water, the venturi meter formula is Q equal to CD into A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. Substituting all numerical values, 0.98 into 0.0314 into 0.00785 divided by 0.0314 square minus 0.00785 square into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 2.268. Calculating Q equal to 0.053 meter cube per second or 53 LPS liters per second. Example number 8 from November 2010 question paper. A venturi meter as shown in the figure with the entrance diameter of 0.3 meter and the throat diameter of 0.15 meter is used to measure the volume of gas flowing through the pipeline. The discharge coefficient of the meter is 0.93. Assuming specific weight of the gas to be constant at 14.5 newtons per meter cube. Calculate the volume flowing when the pressure difference between the entrance and the throat measured as 0.06 meter of water in the U-tube manometer. So the given data, diameter D1 equal to 0.3 meter, D2 equal to 0.15 meter, CD equal to 0.93, X equal to 0.06 meter. Specific weight of the gas is 14.5 newtons per meter cube. So the area of the inlet and the throat section. So if A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, so 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.15 square equal to 0.01766 meter square. So, venturi head of the gas. So, rho gh of the gas equal to rho gh of water. So, rho g 14.5, specific weight of the gas is 14.5 into h equal to rho g of water is 9810 into h equal to 0.06. So, calculating head of the gas column, H equal to 40.59 meter of gas. Then calculating the flow rate of the gas, Q equal to CD into A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. So substituting all numerical values, 0.93, CD equal to 0.93 into 0.07065 into 0.01766 into divided by square root of 0.07065 square minus 0.01766 square into square root of 2 into 9.81 to 40.59 equal to Q equal to 0.4787 meter cube per second. So, the flow rate of gas equal to 0.4787 meter cube per second. Example number 9 from November 2011 question paper, a venturi meter of 150 millimeter by 70 millimeter is used to measure the flow rate of oil having specific gravity 0.9. The reading shown in the U-tube manometer connected to the venturi meter is 150 millimeter of mercury column. Calculate the coefficient of discharge for the venturi meter if the flow rate is 1.7 meter cube per minute. So D1 equal to 0.15 meter, D2 equal to 0.075 meter, X value, the difference in the manometer column is 0.15 meter. Specific gravity of the oil flowing through the venturi meter is 0.9 and the discharge is 1.7 meter cube per minute. So, we calculate the area at the inlet and the throat section, A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.15 square equal to 0.01766 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.075 square equal to 0.0044 meter square. So, the venturi head of the oil H equal to X into Sm divided by S minus 1, which is 0.15 into 13.6 divided by 0.9 minus 1 equal to 2.12 meter. So, the coefficient of discharge of the venturi meter we have to calculate. So, we know Q equal to CD into A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. So, substituting discharge equal to 1.7 meter cube per minute. So, 1.7 divided by 60. CD is the unknown into area 0.01766 into 0.0044 divided by square root of 0.01766 square minus 0.0044 square into square root of 2 into 9.82 into 2.12. So, left hand side is 0.02833, right hand side CD into 0.0293. So, calculating the coefficient of discharge CD equal to 0.967. Example number 10 from May 2013 question paper. A horizontal venturi meter as shown in the figure with the inlet and the throat diameter 30 cm and 15 cm respectively is used to measure the flow rate of water. The reading of the differential manometer connected to the inlet and the throat is 20 cm of mercury. Determine the rate of flow. You take CD equal to 0.98. So we are given D1 equal to 0.3 meter. D2 equal to 0.15 meter, X equal to 0.2 meter, specific gravity of water which is flowing in the venturi meter is 1, CD equal to 0.98. So, area of the inlet and throat section, A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.0706 meter square, A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.15 square equal to 0.01766 meter square. So, the venturi meter of water, venturi head of water, H equal to X into Sm by S minus 1, which is 0.2 into 13.6 divided by 1 minus 1 equal to 2.52 meter. So, the flow rate of water equal to Q equal to CD into A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. So, substituting all numeric values, 0.98 into 0.07065 into 0.01766 divided by 0.07065 square minus 0.01766 square into square root of 2 into 9.81 to 2.52. So, Q equal to 0.1256 meter cube per second, which is 125.6 liters per second. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in the mechanical engineering subject. You may find the fluid mechanics and machinery. For additional problems and the theory part of the subject, what we discuss in the video lecture, you can refer to the book. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We will meet again in another lecture with additional problems on the venturi meter and other flow meters and the fluid dynamics.